What's up, guys? I'm Ashley Jenkins, and today Microsoft has revealed that live streaming to Twitch TV from Xbox One has been delayed until early 2014. Not the most auspicious start to their launch week, right? You can still tune in to watch other streams, like those your friends are broadcasting from their PlayStation 4, just not broadcast yourself. You can even earn media achievements, which don't affect your gamer score at all, but do demonstrate how you use the app by tuning in for marathon sessions or watching around the clock. What you will be able to do instead is use Xbox One's Upload Studio to stitch recorded clips together, add picture-in-picture video via Kinect, and add audio commentary. Then you can upload your edited clip to Xbox Live or to SkyDrive, where you can access it from any smartphone, tablet, or PC, and from there, share it anywhere you want. So for now, at least, it looks as though PS4 is focusing largely on streaming games live, and Xbox is prioritizing providing editing tools for less immediate but more highly polished gameplay videos. They've also released the Windows Phone version of their Smart Glass for Xbox One app, which probably isn't much fun yet, but will be when Xbox One hits shelves this Friday. You can snap content to the TV screen through the app, use it as a remote to control your Xbox One content, or access companion features for Xbox One games while you're playing. Or when you're not at home, you can watch gameplay clips from other Xbox Live players, browse content and watch it on the phone, or if you'd rather wait and watch it on the big screen, pin it to your Xbox One for when you get home. Smart Glass for Xbox One is its own app, so even if you have the 360-compatible version, you'll need to download this one separately. And moving on, the views have been tallied for last month's League of Legends Season 3 World Championship, and we can see why they took so long, because it was the most viewed esports event of all time, with 32 million total viewers and a peak of 8.5 million concurrent spectators from all around the world. The event, which took place at a sold-out Staples Center in Los Angeles, quadrupled its numbers from last year, which pulled in 8.2 million total viewers. In the end, SK Telecom T1 walked away with $1 million prize, with the remaining $1 million prize pool distributed across the other competing teams. Expect next year's Season 4 World Championship to be even bigger, since it will take place in the mecca of esports, South Korea. Finally, Rockstar has announced that their Beach Bum content pack for GTA 5 is now available on Xbox 360 and will be available on PS3 sometime today. The pack was released alongside a 1.06 title update that fixes several vehicle-related bugs and exploits and several UI and character issues. In addition to the patch, they've also tuned the server side of GTA Online. The bad sport penalty for destroying vehicles has been reduced and removed when you're in a tank and someone else runs into you. Missions with higher difficulty now have reward payout multipliers, and restricted vehicles, like police helicopters that players somehow managed to get into their personal garages, have been removed. So if that was you, sorry. To download the Beach Bum pack and gain access to the 30 new missions, 4 new vehicles, 2 new weapons, and new character customization options, you'll need to first download the title update, then trigger the download for the pack. And that's the news. How much does Twitch broadcasting at launch affect whether you'll go PS4 or Xbox One? Let us know what you think in the comments below. Then check out roosterteeth.com, where we'll stream a new episode of our gaming podcast, The Patch, live for sponsors tomorrow.